There is no decision yet on the ballpark. Things are still happening in Winston-Salem that aren't getting nearly the same amount of attention. Kenny Beck joins us live downtown with that story, including news of a big public auction happening next month. Good morning, Kenny.
Kim, good morning to you. While everyone waits out the ballpark funding rain delay of sorts, there are other things happening in downtown Winston-Salem with respect to revitalization and other projects still that are scheduled to happen in the very near future.
From high atop the Nissen building, things look peaceful and picturesque in Winston-Salem. But other views of the city aren't nearly as postcard worthy. Mayor Alan Joynes admits his vision for a revitalized downtown from a few years ago hasn't exactly gone as planned so far.
I think it's more the recession than it is any specific project.
That said, he's still counting on the ballpark, and he believes other businesses are too. But regardless of what happens, other projects are moving forward without nearly the same fuss, like next month's public auction of the old Nash building on 4th Street.
It is a very unique property. Properties like this don't come on the market very often. They certainly aren't auctioned very often.
Property manager Lou Baldwin says the architecture outside and nearly 17,000 vacant square feet inside, some of which needs work, would be perfect for an office, restaurant, or even condos.
This really gives you a sense of some of the antiquity inside the Nash building. You don't see too many chalkboards nowadays, but there's a reason these are still up. This used to be Drawn Business College. It was really big back in the 1950s and 60s. Just about every secretary in Winston-Salem came here to train.
Bidders are also vying for the property rights to the already leased business space on the lower level.
I think everybody's excited. The building's undergoing a lot of revitalization right now as we speak, and in recent years with new tenants. And I think most of them look at it as an opportunity that maybe a new owner will do something with the upstairs of the building that's been vacant for a number of years and help bring more customers to the street.
Others leading the downtown revitalization charge say that's the idea.
We know that we don't have the resources to put a whole bunch of retail everywhere throughout downtown, so we need to consolidate it and pack it together into one walkable area.
And to some extent, that's already happening. Take a brief walk on or around 4th Street and you'll find a new clothing store, new restaurants, new gym, and a soon-to-be-open shoe store. Proof, some would say, that before too long, downtown will look as good from the ground level as it does from high above.
Nash building for a moment. It's more than 80 years old. Its assessed property tax value is about $1.7 million. Difficult to say how much it will go for when it goes up for public auction on July 15th at noon. But at the very least, we should know the status of the ballpark by then. At least we should know the status of the ballpark by then. But of course, we thought we would know the status of the ballpark many, many months ago.
That is so true. All right. Well, hopefully it'll move forward. Thank you, Kenny.